Have you ever looked at a photo that someone shared online and wondered, like, what did they do to get it to look that way? Or maybe you just thought, like, what would I do if I had the ability to edit that photo myself? Maybe you like me and you just enjoy everything involved with sharing your photo for both inspirational and educational reasons. If you find yourself nodding with what I'm saying, then you definitely need to spend more time in the Lightroom's community section because it is easily one of the ecosystem's most underrated features. The Lightroom community really is a tremendous resource for inspiration, education, and as I'll show you in a minute, tons of free Lightroom presets. You can access the Lightroom community from each of the cloud-based services, including Lightroom desktop, mobile, and web. And I've been spending a lot more time recently in the Lightroom community because it really is filled with some truly talented photographers who not only share their photos, and this is key, they also share their editing workflows from start to finish. Because of that, it's become my absolute favorite place to share my photos, and I'm going to show you why right now. So let's dive in. All right, so here we are in Lightroom desktop, and it could be understandable if you overlook community because it's sandwiched in between some really important sections. You've got, for example, the ability to add your photos to your cloud library. You've got your all photos view with these filters, and then you've got your folders and your albums where your images are actually stored. And so community is right over here, but before I dive into it, I want to also show you Learn. Learn is just also one of those hidden gems. And I might do a separate video specifically on it. If you're interested in a deep dive in Learn, let me know in the comments. But really quickly, what Learn is, it's an area where if you're new to Lightroom or you're just not sure how to do something, you want to learn a technique, this is one of the best places for it because it's really an interactive tutorial section. You can filter by all of these different options here. And then let's say there is a tutorial that you're interested in, like this rock and roll photo of Dave Grohl. So if you click on it, you'll get a little bit more info about the tutorial. And then when you start the tutorial, this is what separates, I would say, Lightroom from most, pretty much any other app. You're gonna get an intro into what you're about to do. And it's not like you click continue and you're told, like, just move the exposure slider. You are given context about what the slider does. So let's start by adding lightning to the overall image. So you actually move the slider. It doesn't just like move it for you or anything, but it actually allows you to play around with this and it guides you where the slider should go. And then again, things like we're not telling you just decrease highlights. It's actually giving you context saying there are a few overexposed stage lights on the image. Let's darken them to bring attention back to Dave. Like I absolutely love this. And so you can go through this on your own pace at your own time. And I think it's absolutely wonderful. So again, if you're interested in learning more about this, let me know. But really what I want to do is focus on community. So again, community. Community is accessible from Lightroom desktop, as you see right here, but it's also accessible if you're using Lightroom mobile. On the iPhone, you'll see the community button on the very bottom right. Same thing with the iPad, it's on the bottom. All you need to do is tap on it and pretty much everything that you see here in this video will operate the same on mobile. It might just have a slightly different way to get to certain areas, but everything is there. So let's go ahead and let's expand community. So when you click on it, this is kind of the main area of community. And so you can see sections like daily inspiration, as well as featured images, trending, and then just some get inspired sections in the popular categories. Now, when you look at an image here, you'll see a few things. You'll see the image itself, you'll see the creator of the image, and then these two icons. The left icon is how many times that image has been remixed. I'll go over that in a minute. And then how many times the image has been liked. And again, you have filter options here. So you can see only images that can be remixed. And you can control this. I'll show you that as well. I'm going to share an image to the community and I'll show you the options that you have. You can also filter by images that allow you to download the preset and then also by the subject matter. Now let's move on to my profile. So obviously this is my profile. You can see my avatar here, a little bit of a bio about me, and then where I'm based out of, my website and my social links. You can also customize the banner image here. Now, these are the images that I've been sharing. I started using community, like I said, pretty recently. And so I try to make it a point at least once a day, sometimes twice a day to share an image to community. And it, to me, it's just the most fun. So you can see here the images. Now, this image was actually featured. You can see a little blue ribbon here, and it tells you it was featured on December 6th. That's why it kind of has a bunch of remixes and a bunch of likes, which is nice. I really do appreciate that. Then we have a featured filter that shows all of the featured images over here. We have a filter to show you all of the images that were shared by people that you're following. So you could follow people. For example, Katrine Eisman is a dear friend and a colleague of mine on the Lightroom team at Adobe. She actually has the Herculean job of going through and making sure that, you know, all of the photos you see here are good. There's not anything kind of spammy or anything. And she's kind of the community queen in Lightroom. Here's Rick Floor, who's another good friend and dear Adobe colleague of mine on the Lightroom team. So it's just cool to see people sharing their stuff. But it's not just that. And really, this is what sets everything apart. Like, yes, I've shared a bunch of photos to Instagram, and you get to look at it, and within a split second, you're already off to something else. The photo doesn't do anything to fill you up. It doesn't inspire necessarily, and it certainly doesn't educate. And this is the difference. So let's go back to my profile here, and let's actually go to the featured photo. So this is amazing. This is amazing. What you see here on the right is the full edit stack, everything I did to this photo from start to finish. But here's what's cool about it. You don't just have a list of edits. If you click in the image here, you'll see that it's actually stepping through each of the edits, and you see what the impact of that edit has on the photo. And so it'll go through this whole thing. But let's say you're like, oh, you know what? I want to really focus on the effect of the point curve. And so I can click here and it kind of pauses on this step, and then I can click next, and you can see the impact of these particular point curve adjustments, which I think is super cool. And then you can go down here and you're like, all right, I see there's a mask. So what does that mask do? And you're like, oh, cool. So to me, that's one of the absolute coolest things about the community section in Lightroom. Now, along the bottom, you'll see these other thumbnails in a film strip. So these are remixes. So if you enable the option to remix an image, you'll see a button here when you click on it called Remix. And I'll show you what remixing looks like in a minute. But basically what it'll do is it'll open up this image in the community section with the full Lightroom editing stack. So you can start from the original image, from as shot, and go to town. You can crop, you can use gen remove, you can use anything you want to edit the photo. And then when you save it, you can basically see what other people have done with your image. Now, they don't have access to your image. They can't export it. It's just there in the community section. And the great thing is you can share kind of your take on an image with anyone else. So you can see, as I click on the images, you see their edit stack, and you can play through it as they edited the photo. Like here, this person decided to give a 16:9 crop, which is cool. Like, I hadn't considered that. And so to me, honestly, the two things here that I just showed you, the ability to walk through the entire edit stack and the ability to remix a photo with your own creative vision, I think those are some of the most powerful things for the Lightroom community. Now let's go ahead. I'm going to walk you through sharing a photo. You can share a photo to community on any of Lightroom surfaces. So here again, I'm on Lightroom desktop. But again, if you've got your photo, you're on your iPhone, your iPad, or your Android device, and you want to share it to community, you can do that. So I've got this edited photo, and if I hit the backslash key, this is the original unedited version. And this is what I did to edit it. And so I'm going to go ahead and click on the share button up here. And you'll see there's a section here. Again, you might have overlooked this. Share to community. I'm going to click on it. And here you have some ability to customize the image. So I'm going to start with a title. And I'll call this Hokkaido Lighthouse. I decided to go extra punchy with the contrast and color for this shot. So I'm giving a little description of my editing process. And then you can select three categories here if you want. You need at least one. So I'm going to start with, I'll start with travel. Then I'll go with maybe landscape, and then architecture, since there's kind of a lighthouse over here. Of course, you can do something else. Like if you want nature, you can do nature. It's totally up to you. It's just basically will help filter the image for viewers. Then you've got some permissions options. The first one is the ability to allow people to save your edit stack as a preset. So you can enable that or disable it. It's totally up to you. I'll show you what it looks like in the community. And then if there is a geotagged information and you want to show it, you can include that there. I generally don't do that. And then this is the most important one, in my opinion, is allow remixing. I think that's one of the best parts about community. And so I always enable that. Let's go ahead also and enable save as preset. And then I'm going to go ahead and click on share. And so that's all you really need to do. What's happening is your image is being uploaded to community. It takes a few minutes. You'll see here that the edit is still processing. So basically what it's doing is it's working through the edit stack. There it is. You can see you also get the ability to share it. So you can share this with people. You can copy that link to your clipboard. Or you can share it to Facebook or X right away. I'm going to close out over here. And so now you can see if I click play, it's going to walk through the entire image from start to finish. And so let's pause this here. Because I enabled the option to save as a preset, you can see over here there's a button which will allow you to save this edit stack as a preset. And then, of course, if you click on remix, you'll be able to remix. I don't want to remix my own photo. I'm just going to go to the community here. Let's go to following, so like people who I'm following. And then I'm going to go to this waterfall photo taken again by my friend and colleague, Rick Floor. So I'm going to click on remix. And so again, this is amazing. It brings Rick's image here, and I've got pretty much the entire editing stack. So I can go ahead, for example, maybe try to get a custom white balance. Rick did a good job. You know, it's quite neutral already. I'm going to go here, you know, just apply a quick edit, you know, open up the black point a little bit. Let's drop the highlights a bit, open the shadows up. Let's change the profile to Adobe Landscape. Add one of my beloved S curves, because you know me, I love a good S curve. Let's add a little bit of gray into the blacks over here. I'm going to go ahead and cool it off a bit manually, somewhere right around there. Then let's go to color calibration and increase the blue primary saturation, probably one of the most underrated and most powerful sliders in all of Lightroom. I've got a video all about that. Then let's go ahead here and add a tiny bit of clarity and texture. We'll go to masking here. Let's zoom way out. Add a radial gradient here. And even though there's no direct sun, I will add just a tiny bit of a glow, something like that. So with that there, I'm going to go to dehaze. Add a negative dehaze. I'm going to zoom back out really quickly, move that in a bit more, something like that. See that little glow that it's giving me? And then I'm also going to warm that glow, increase the highlights a bit. I'm going to back off the negative dehaze a little bit there. And let's finish things up. Let's add a little bit of sharpening. And mask it out from areas that we don't want sharpening, and then wrap things up with a post crop vignette. And I'd say we're looking good. And so we can hit the backslash key. That is what we started with. Those are my edits over there. I'm going to click on next. And then you can give Rick a little note like, I loved this photo, Rick. Thanks for letting me remix it. Post remix. And there you go. So now other people can see that I remixed the photo. They can walk through my edits. And if I click here, I'll go back to my profile and you can see there is a section here for remixed photos. And so there it is over there. And so often what I do when I'm not sharing a photo to my own community profile, I'll often just go to community over here and I'm just gonna look at what people have shared. I like that when you hover over, you see the unedited version. So you can get an idea really quickly, the editing process. And also it might be something that just inspires you to like give it a shot, give a remix a shot if remixing is enabled. Now, as you share stuff to the community, people can interact with it. They can remix and they can like it. And so if you wanna see those updates, up here, there's a little bell icon and you see there's a little blue dot next to it. That means that you've got unread notifications. So when you click on it, you'll get basically a little wall here of what people have done in terms of interacting or engaging with your photos. So you can see that a bunch of people have been liking the Venice shot. Someone remixed my photo from Port Townsend. So you can click over here and go straight to that. And don't forget, if there's someone that you're like, oh, I really like what they did, right next to their name is the ability to follow them. So I can go ahead and click on follow. And there, now I'm following Natalia. I hope you found this video fun and inspiring and actually educational, because that I do think is something that's missing from a lot of apps. I'm not just picking on photo editing apps, but just apps in general, especially creativity apps, where there is not always a resource right in the app to help you fully understand what the tools are, and especially the ability for you to kind of engage with other people's work. That's why I think the community section in the Lightroom is truly worth highlighting here. I hope you give it a shot, especially if you're on mobile, like you're just around and you want to share one of your photos, or you just want to do a quick edit while you're on the go. I think that's super cool that you can do that. And don't forget, this is a wonderful area to find a bunch of presets. If you're the kind of person who really enjoys kind of building your preset collection, there are plenty of people who not only share their photos to community, not only give you the ability to remix them, but also the ability to save a preset of their edit stack, which I think is truly wonderful. So don't forget about that as well. Now, I mentioned that I have a video about the color calibration panel and why I think it is so powerful. Check that out over here. Of course, if you found this video helpful, a thumbs up is always appreciated. And please be sure to click on the subscribe button and the bell icon to get notified of all future videos. Thanks a lot, everyone.